You're welcome into the presence of the Lord. And I pray that the grace of the Lord will continue to be with you in the mighty name of Jesus. Without wasting much of our time, we go straightly through this message of today. And I title it, The Way Out of Wrong Ideology. The Way Out of Wrong Ideology. For those that have been following us in this teaching, you will recall that last 2 weeks we talked about the reality of ideology and the power of ideology. That is, the life of a man is governed by a certain set of ideology. And I said, when a thought comes into your heart, it is easy for that thought to change. But the moment that thought grows to form and become an ideology, it becomes difficult for that belief system to change from your heart. Because thought is the seed of ideology. That is, it is the thought that comes into your heart that grows to become an ideology. Just as the seed that produces a pregnancy is different from a child, so a thought is different from ideology. That is, the moment that a thought enters into your heart, it grows to become a belief. And a belief becomes an ideology. So when a thought enters into your heart, it is easy for that thought to be aborted. But the moment that thought becomes repeated, the moment you are listening to a certain information again and again, there is tendency for that thought or that information that becomes a thought to grow to become an ideology. So ideology is not formed in a day. It's either you are born into a certain set of ideology or you grow in it. So when it comes to ideology, before something can become an ideology, you must have grown in a certain system or in a certain environment. So, and we have a right ideology and we have a wrong ideology. And one of the effects of a wrong ideology is that it becomes a pattern, a way of life that will not produce a good result in the life of a man. It becomes a pattern, it becomes a way of life that a generation will begin to grow into, and that same way of life will not produce a good result in the life of those that are living by that principle, and at the end of the day, they will not have ability to change that principle because that principle is a product of a certain ideology that is manifesting in their life. Let me give a practical example. We grew up to discover in Africa that academic is a key to success. And because of that belief system, a certain principle was drawn in order for us to attain that academic excellence. So we wake up to discover that we finish primary six and we go to secondary school. We discover that we finish secondary school, we were told to write a jam, and we find ourselves writing a jam. And after writing a jam, we find ourselves in a university. And we suddenly discover that after the university, we discover that the academic that they told us that is the key to success, it becomes a key to generational poverty. That is the reason why many people even fail is because they go to school. It has become a system whereby the reason why many people are failing in Africa is simply because they go to school. Is academic a bad thing? No. But there is a system that formed that ideology in Africa that make it not to produce results. So we lost the focus of academic. We now begin to pass to read, to pass a to pass the test in school instead of us to read so that we can pass the test of life. Katole Moshanda, I read. We now begin to read in order to pass an examination, to pass a test of school, instead of us to read and study so that we can pass the test of life. So you now see somebody who came out with distinction, came out with first class, now failing the test of life. And the purpose of academic, the purpose of education is not so that you can pass a test in the school, but it is so that you can pass the test of life. But the kind of system of academic system of Africa is the one given to us, so we are reading to pass exam. Because most of the thing we are studying in school has nothing to do with our destiny assignment in life. Because education is the art of going into school so that you study more on what you are destined to do in life. That is, you go to obtain formal information on what you have been destined to do in life. That is, you go to obtain formal training on what you have been destined to do in life. But we got to discover that we are not studying what we are destined to do in life. We are just studying what is raining. One, some people are just studying so that they just don't want to, they want to leave home. They just want to go to school. So any course given to them, they accept it. And at the end of the day, somebody will now waste good 5 years. And after NYC, they discover that the certificate is not useful in life. Why? We grow up in a wrong ideology that gives us wrong definition of what education is all about. So right from NYC, they now begin to tell us that we should learn vocation. And that vocation they are asking us to learn is the real education. So you now come to us that we now got the full meaning of the realistic of NYC, which simply means now your struggle continue. NYCE. Why? But the fact is that when we now begin to face the reality of life, it dawned on us that most of what we were taught in school has no relevance to the reality of our destiny in the society. 95% of what we use 5 years to study has nothing to do with the reality of solving the problem of life. And there's nothing we can do because it has become an ideology. It has become a belief system that everybody is growing to follow that pattern until some set of people arose and begin to challenge that belief system. Less, we won't have solution. Because get this and get this again. Man is ordained to rebel against change. It is the nature of man to rebel against change. We like system, we like protocol, we like to follow others. This is the way they are doing it in 1992. So don't let us change it. We like to fight against anything called civilization, and that is the mystery behind the backwardness of Africa. Inability to challenge a system in order to come out with something valuable is a problem of many in Africa. So most of the things that we are living with, they are the things that have been programmed in our intelligence since we were born. Let me give this practical example so that we know the reality of what I'm talking about. We grow up to know that the electricity corporation that we grow up to know is NEPA. Even though till now, what has been programmed in our intelligence, in our memory, is NEPA. Even though it has turned to, what has it turned to now? NDC. Even me, I didn't even know what it has turned to. There was that, it was PACL. So every child that grew up that was not even in existence when NEPA was NEPA knew that once there is light, it is NEPA. Is an ideology. That is, we struggle to adapt to something that is new. We are used to a pattern that has been existing, and that is the problem of many also in the body of Christ. You see them talking about the revival of 1930, inability to see into the future, to bring the reality ahead into today is the problem of Africa. Wrong ideology. A white man will sit down and begin to imagine the realistic of the thing that may happen in the 2090 and begin to reason on how to form it and make it a reality in 2021. But an African man will begin to think of revival of 1930. When the Bible says, all things are passed away. Behold, I will do a new thing. When Paul said, I forget the former thing. When God himself said let me remember the scripture. He said that he has not come into the heart of man that the things that God will do. It should be 1 Corinthians or 2 Corinthians. 1 Corinthians, yeah. The hearts have The heart of the eyes have not seen, and the heart have not received the things that God will do. So what simply means the God we serve is not a God that repeats patterns. When you see God, if God begins to repeat things, it means God has short of ideas. And God is not the God that is short of ideas. He's a man that releases new things in every season. You cannot use the past move to predict the move of God in every season. You can't. The way God lead the Israelites to cross the Red Sea is not the same pattern he lead them to lead to pass through River Jordan. To Moses, he told him, what is that in your hand? Take the rod. But to Joshua, he told him, do not let the book to depart from your hand. Assuming Nigeria happened to be in the day of Moses, they will go and be looking for that wood and make it and build a temple around it. Everybody will not be going and be organizing camp meeting with that same road. We like to think and bring the past into the present. And the moment you don't have the ability to change a system, you become the slave of that system. Because to every dispensation, there should be a new system to govern the intelligence and the reality of man. You cannot use the system that worked in 1960 to begin to think that same system will be the pattern through which the existence of man will be formed in this season. There must be change. Now the question is, how can you be free from wrong ideology? How can you be free from wrong ideology? How? Because that is the point. Because a message is not complete if we did not talk about the solution. When you read a book that gives you the reality of a thing, give you the purpose of a thing, and that book did not give you how or way out, that book is not yet a book of wisdom. A book is divine to be a book of wisdom when it has the ability to tell you what. Have the ability to tell you what, to tell you how. No, to tell you why. It has the ability to tell you how or way out. So it must pass the test of what, the test of why, and the test of how. What talks about knowledge. Why talks about understanding. Why how talks about wisdom. That is when you are defining the meaning of a thing. What is this? You are expressing the reality of knowledge. When you now begin to talk about why, you are talking about the purpose. And that is understanding. That is, you are launching the intelligence of man into the realm of understanding, where they will begin to have the accurate information about how things are formed, or how things look like, or why things are formed today. Why things are formed. But if you stop there, information is not complete until you begin to launch a man into the realm where you tell them how or way out. If it is something good, you tell them how. If it is something wrong, you tell them way out. I repeat, if it is something positive, you tell them how. And if it is something negative, you tell them way out. Now the question is, what is the way out of wrong ideology? What is the way into the right ideology? Yeah.
I repeat,
what is the way out into wrong ideology? And what is the way into the right ideology? Because show me your result, I will tell you the ideology that is governing your life. And Paul said in the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 10, he said the weapon of our warfare, he said they are not carnal, but mighty in pulling down struggle. I use this opportunity to tell you that wrong ideology simply means struggle. When a wrong ideology is forming you, it makes you to resist some certain information that has the ability to transform your life into a certain level to another certain level. Because you are used to a pattern of a belief system. It now becomes a stronghold. It becomes a belief. And Paul was not telling us, he was giving us a certain mystery in that Bible verse. He said, cast it down, imagination. That is, they move, cast it down a stronghold, pull it down a stronghold, then cast it down imagination. It didn't say cast out. You don't cast out stronghold, you cast it down. There is a difference between casting out and cast it down. When it comes to demon, you cast it out. When it comes to imagination and stronghold, you cast it down, you pull it down. And the instrument of casting out is different from the instrument of pulling down. By fire, you cast out. By light, you put down. So, where Paul is now saying the weapon of our warfare are not carnal, mighty in pulling down a stronghold, that weapon means light. When a certain higher revelation enters into your spirit, it has the ability to change your ideology. Maleko shente ligada. Makatali moshete likato ligada. Let me show you a scripture. Matthew chapter 6 verse 23. Matthew 6 23. Look at what it says. It says, if the eyes be evil, the whole body shall be full of darkness. If therefore the light that is in thee be darkness, how great is the darkness? Pay attention. If light that is in you is darkness, the question is, how can light be darkness? We know light to be opposite of darkness. We know light, we know darkness to be the opposite of light. But Jesus is now saying here that when your light is darkness, another version said, when your light look like darkness, or when what you think is light is darkness. Can't tell him Oshanda Lagada. Yeah. New Living Translation is that if the light you think you have is darkness, so there is tendency to carry a darkness and you think it is light. The moment you have that orientation, that is what we call wrong ideology. That is, it's a certain darkness that look like light. Katolimo shanda ka ulike teligada. Get this, when a darkness is in you, it is called ignorant. That is, when a darkness is in you, it is called ignorant. But when a darkness is in you, and you think that darkness is light, it is called wrong ideology. Because there is difference between somebody who is ignorant and somebody who is with wrong ideology. Somebody who is with wrong ideology, they are the people that did not know, but they think they know. Somebody that is ignorant, he did not know, and he know that he did not know.
I repeat.
There are differences between when there is darkness in you and when there is darkness in you and you think that darkness is light. When there is darkness in you, the manifestation of darkness is ignorance. And when you are ignorant, you will not know, and you will know that you will not know. That you did not know that. That's it. You did not know, and you know that you did not know. That is ignorant. The wrong ideology is when you did not know and you think you know. Katolimo shindala. And that's what Jesus is saying here. He said, when the darkness in you, if the light you think you have is darkness, he said, how deep is that darkness? So there is one thing to have a darkness in you, and there is another thing to have a deep darkness in you. In the book of Isaiah 60, it said, "Arise and shine, for your light has come." He now said in the next verse, he said, "Darkness has covered the head." He said, "Gross darkness covered the people." So there is difference between darkness and gross darkness. Isaiah 60 verses 2. Is that right? Verse 1 and 2. "Arise and shine, for your light has come." Next verse. It said, "Darkness has covered the earth." The next statement is that gross darkness cover people. There is difference between when darkness cover the earth and when gross darkness cover people. Gross darkness doesn't cover earth, it cover people. Why darkness cover the earth? Darkness, when darkness cover the earth, you will not be able to see. You will have eyes, but you will not be able to see. But when gross darkness cover people, there will be light, but there will not be eyes to see. There is difference between when you have eyes and there is no light. From where you have, when there is light and there is no eyes. Blindness is when there is light and there is no eyes. And for those who are born again, they are in light. We have many people who are in light, but they are blind. Because Paul, the Bible says, the God of this earth has what? Has blindfolded. Those who are not born again, they are in darkness. But there are many people who are in light, but they are blind. And there is no difference between somebody who is in light and blind and somebody who has two eyes in darkness. You can just close your eyes and you see the example. You see that there is no difference between somebody that is in light and doesn't have eyes and somebody that have eyes but where? In darkness. So Paul now said, and Isaiah now said, he said, darkness has covered the earth. Gross darkness cover people. So gross darkness is the one that become a veil. It will not allow you to see. So, and the solution to be free is when higher light comes to you. The solution to wrong ideology is higher light. When you receive a certain knowledge, there is tendency for that ideology in you to change. And that light is of two. Right? We have two kinds of light. We have the light of revelation and the light of civilization. Let me give you a practical example of the light of civilization that has the ability to change the ideology of a man. Tell me your belief. Maybe you belong to a church that pray, maybe fall and die by fire, or you have a certain doctrine that doctrine is because you are born and brought up in Africa. Just change the environment to UK. People have given you Bible references on that ideology for long, but change the environment. Nobody will tell you. The light of civilization will make you to know that thing you once believed is wrong. You can't be praying the way we are praying in Africa and get to UK for 5 years and still be praying like that. Because your ideology will change. Because most of our prayer pattern is a product of deep ignorance. And most of our prayer points in Africa is also a product of deep ignorance. At times, when we are sweating, we are praying, we think it's a product of heresy. We don't know it's a product of ignorance. Time will not permit us. Next teaching, we will talk about that. You will see how power of ideology, how light of civilization can change the ideology of a man. There are many cultures we eradicated in Africa, not because light of revelation came to that environment, but because civilization came. There are some communities that if they want to worship their God in the hedges, it was a white man, or it was a man or a virgin that they used as a sacrifice. But as civilization began to increase, they started using cow. Now, when they discover that cow is becoming expensive, they change it to white fowl. Now, self, it's only shinap. Those God is only taking shinap now. And the fact is that it wasn't that maybe Christianity entered into that environment, but a certain civilization come, and it opened their understanding to a certain better way of living, and they begin to naturally eradicate those cultures.
power of civilization. He has the ability to change ideology. Go to where, go to northern part of Nigeria today. The reason why some of them are still bound into some ideology they carry is because civilization has no entry into that environment. Civilization is a powerful tool. At times when I see the way Africa, we know we talk about tithing, we attach tithing to poverty. It is because of your ideology. Ideology is what makes you to think that if you don't tithe, you'll be poor. It's a wrong ideology. Because nobody will force you. Nobody will even show Bible to you. Nobody will correct you. Nobody will tell you that you is not a New Testament doctrine. You go to UK, stay 5 years there. You will know that without tithing, you will be rich. I was listening to a man of God when he was preaching to his congregation in Africa. Because most of all these generals here, once they travel out, there are many things they teach here, they dare not try to teach it over there. Because they know that they are talking to an enlightened and exposed followers. But in Africa, it is easy for African man to be brainwashed. Because it is Africa, you will see that somebody will be going to church, he will hold his Bible and put his brain at home. So he carries his Bible to the church and leave his brain at home. So, and people like that, they are very easy to blow. So the pastor, the man of God, to his congregation in Nigeria, he said, if you don't tithe, you'll be poor. That's what he said to his congregation in Nigeria. He now get to outside the country. He now tell them there that if you don't tithe, you will still come back to poverty. He told them in Nigeria that if you don't tithe, you will be poor. You can't be rich. That's what he said. So that you can never be rich if you don't tithe. He now get there. He know that they are rich already without tithe. He now said, if you don't tithe, you will still come back. I was just laughing. That will not permit us. We do enough doctrinal teaching on the matter of tithing. I think if possible in our next teaching. You will know that when you have a deep relationship with God, it is an insult to give God 10%. It's an insult. To give God 10%. Two. And it's an insult to be under the bondage of 10%. It's an insult to the integrity of what Christ has done on the cross. The Bible didn't say you will tithe. It said he became poor so that you can be rich. It didn't say you tithe so that you can be rich. You can be rich. So we are not under the law of Malachi. And if you say we are following Abraham, I use this opportunity to tell you that Abraham only paid tithe once. He paid tithe once. And he's already rich when he paid tithe. So he didn't pay tithe so that he can be rich. He's already rich. I do tell people, I said, if you want to teach with intelligence, tell people the purpose of a thing. Let men know the purpose of tithing to church, not in purpose of tithing to their life. When you are telling them the purpose of tithing to their life, it is brainwash. But tell them the purpose of tithing to the development of the church. Full-time pastor needs it to survive. Let them know. It is this tithe we use to pay the salary of the full-time pastor. Let them know that is intelligent enough. If you don't tell them, if they don't give, they will be poor. Who told you? If you don't give, you will be rich. Let them know the importance of giving to the advancement of the kingdom. The Bible says that it is by prosperity that the gospel will be spread abroad. Let them know the importance of what they are giving to, not the importance of the giving to their own life. It is selfishness. You are brainwashing them when you are telling them the advantage of giving to their own life. Because I know a stingy man who are rich. As any teacher that doesn't pass the test of logic, don't come out to teach us in this dispensation. You are not for this generation if you are teaching below logic. Men must be able to reason what you are saying. One, two, your teaching must pass the test of common sense. Two, your teaching must pass the test of divine wisdom. Don't teach below common sense. Huh? You tell me if I don't tithe, I will be poor. And I look around, I saw thousands of people who are not tithing and they are rich. That is not logic. most of our pastors, that's why they are facing enough criticism in the social media. That's the reason. Because they don't have the ability to communicate the current message of this generation. So what they teach in 1930, in 1990, that they receive applause, they are trying to think they will teach it again. They don't know that they are talking to intelligent generation. Generation who doesn't keep their sense in their pocket. They will reason what you are saying logically. And if it doesn't pass the test of logic, you fail the test to penetrate your message into the heart. So For without your doctrinal teaching on tithing, I don't need to argue with you. You travel out. Stay 5 years in USA. The power of civilization is enough to change your ideology. You say, if you don't wear trousers, if you don't wear trousers, you will go to a fire. It's an ideology. You travel to UK and stay 10 years. Nobody will tell you to wear trousers. You just suddenly discover that you are wearing it as a lady. Because environment, civilization has the power to change your ideology. Because your ideology now is a product of environment. And to get out of that ideology, you also need to move from one place to another. Until you change location, your ideology may not change. That's why, because ideology, one of it is a product of listening to something the other. If you go to some churches now that you don't even believe their doctrine, and you stay in that church today, next tomorrow you are there, you are listening to that message for a good 1 year, before you know what is happening, that message will begin to form an ideology in you, and you begin to discover that it's becoming true. Anything you listen to consistently has the capacity to become an ideology. And if you want to change your ideology, one, change what you listen to. Two, change your environment. You just already discovered that a new ideology came. So power of civilization. Two, is power of revelation. When the light of the Lord hits you, the Bible said, the weapon of our warfare are not carnal. He said they are mighty in pulling down light of revelation. It can put down a certain philosophy, a certain belief system out of you. So light is the key to wrong ideology. And the light is of two types. One, light of civilization, and the light of what? Revelation. And I pray God bless you in Jesus' name.